We welcome you to WOSN's annual Stolly Hustle Award show. Each and every week during our basketball and football seasons, we named a Stolly Hustle Award player for our TV44 and WOSN broadcast. Then all of our announcers got to vote on their top five hustlers for football season and top five hustlers for basketball season. We'll present those five with plaques today. I was going to say trophies, but plaques today, courtesy of our friends at Stolly Insurance. Jared Stolly joins me here once again. And it's just been such a beautiful partnership between TV44 and Stolly Insurance all these years. Everywhere we go, Stolly Hustle is synonymous with high school sports.
We appreciate that partnership, and I think it's a great tie. It actually started in 1988.
Wow.
28 years ago,
okay.
Which I know 28 because that's when I was born. So it's easy to count. But for us, we feel the hustle is such an overused word, I think,
yeah.
In sports especially. And we'd say talk is cheap in our business. Talk is cheap. You know, it's what you do.
Yeah.
And coaches yell hustle. You got to grind it out. But these kids that are going to get these plaques, you'll hear them consistently humble, and they're always talking about other people. Outside the court and field work they do, that's how they get this award each year, and a testament to their family and friends and coaches, and it's what you do, and it's not what you say.
Right. Well, we appreciate Stolly Insurance looking out for us, looking out for the community, and looking out for you as well as we present to you the Stolly Hustle Award All Team for football.
Man in motion. We'll see if the Flyers decide to put it in the air. It's going to be a keeper by Ligers. Picks up a nice block as he gets around the corner. He's down to the 20. Makes a guy miss and has a convoy into the end zone for a touchdown. Ligers with a 43-yard scamper, and Marion Local is first on the board. This is Ligers on first down. Once it all on first down, and Colling is there to make the catch and the touchdown.
What's the word hustle mean to you, first Wayne?
It just means work hard, do your best, just go out every day and do your best you can, just lead for others and work hard.
Second week of the season, big game against Macomb, you know, thinking back to back in the fall, what did that win mean for you guys as a team starting your season off 2-0?
It was a huge step for us. We knew Macomb was coming back with a lot of kids from the previous year. We knew it was going to be a good matchup, and we just came out and played really good against Macomb. It was a heck of a game for us.
What a season. What will you remember? I mean, state championship probably, but what are some of the moments for your senior year that you'll remember?
Macomb is a huge game we remember just because they were good. And then we came around the next week and played a very good Coldwater team. And kind of just sets in your heart because, you know, we had a chance to win it, but we didn't. And just all the memories that I had with all the guys going out every day with the seniors, competing, just having a blast out there. And then we just won the state game to finish it off. It was a heck of a season.
Take us through that state week. What do you remember about the week leading up to it and then your whole experience in Columbus?
The week leading up really wasn't the funnest. I mean, we were just working as hard as we could. Us seniors knew that we wanted to get it done this year, so there wasn't too much goofing off in practice that week. We just wanted to get it done, and then the experience was great at Columbus, and just woke up in the morning and we knew it was game day, and we just wanted to go out there and get it done, and started off good and then kind of went downhill, but ended up in our favor.
What was that second half like? Just trying to hang on and not have what happened last year?
It was nerve-wracking as can be. I mean, I think all of our seniors' hearts felt like they were going to pop out of our chest at one moment. I mean, but once that final play happened, it was the greatest feeling ever, just knowing that we won.
Marion Local High School, what will you, as you think back, what will you remember about this school?
Just all the support everybody has for you around this community, this school. Everybody's willing to help you out if you need some. Everybody's there for each other. And there's no one there to really shoot you down. Everybody's picking you up and ready to move on in life.
Speaking of moving on in life, tell us your plans for after high school.
I'm going to go to Ohio State Lima for 1 year, and then I'm going to transfer to Ohio State, and I'm going to try to become a civil engineer.
All right, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
There's a sideline pass. Kaufman, first down. Slant down to the goal line and a touchdown. Kaufman found Richie Knowlton.
Jay Kaufman, quarterback, Stolle Hustle winner. What does hustle mean to you?
Hustle is just, you know, going out there every play, every down of every game, giving your all, not taking plays off.
The game you won for was St. Mary's, down at St. Mary's. That was a bit of an upset that you guys pulled off. What do you remember about that game?
That was a very memorable game. I don't think many people expected us to go in there and win. That got us a share of the WBL, and it had been a while since OG has won a WBL championship in football. The WBL is pretty tough, so you know, game in and game out, you can't really take games off. You never know who's going to win, really.
As quarterback, what sort of extra opportunities do you have to show hustle?
It seems like, for the most part, every play starts with you, so all eyes are usually on you at the start, so you got to be hustling and be a leader to the rest of your teammates. I'll have to take even more of a leadership role next season. The younger kids will definitely be looking up to all of us seniors, really, leading by example and by what we say and what we tell them to do.
And any idea about future plans yet?
Not real sure. As of right now, I'm thinking maybe majoring in engineering or business and then possibly play a sport. It just kind of depends.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Holman again. And he bursts up the middle. He might get to the end zone again. And Will Holman has his fourth rushing touchdown in the first half. Holman. Up the middle, Holman with more room to run. Helm is headed for the end zone, and he's in from 28 yards out.
Toss to Holman. Oh, my goodness. If he gets in the end zone, this is the play of the week.
Yes, it is.
Wow. He not only stopped and went lateral, he jumped back to avoid a tackler.
What's hustle mean to you? Stolle Hustle, all hustle team, what's that word mean to you?
It just means that you give it all for your team every single play, and you're going to die for your team.
What was your hardest game of the year when you talk about intensity and effort this year, where you really felt you had to hustle extra?
I would say probably both games versus Minster. I mean, second game didn't end the way we wanted it to, but I mean, both those games, the whole team was involved, hustling around the whole field, and one ended the way we wanted to, the other one didn't.
Walk me through the Ada game. What was that game like for you?
The Ada game was awesome. I mean, it was kind of just the lineman parted the Red Sea every single play. I mean, I got touched maybe twice, but it was a great game. Yeah.
State championship 2 years ago. Just what was that dream like for Fort Recovery? You'd never done that to go and win it all.
Well, it was just incredible. I did it with my brother was on the team and a bunch of seniors. All those seniors were going to die for each other. I mean, they made that goal that we were going to go to state and win the state championship that winter before. And just help them carry it forward was awesome.
Getting ready for your senior season, but not before baseball. How excited are you to be outside this spring?
Oh, it's awesome. I mean, going out and playing baseball is one of my sports I was brought up playing and probably my one growing up. Now it's football, but it's great to go out there and play with your team and hopefully make another state run this year in baseball.
Plans for the future? Are you still kind of working through that? Do you have a sport you'd like to play in college if possible?
If I could play football, I would enjoy to play that in college. But end of the day, I'm going into nursing, so I want to make sure I can find a good nursing school that I can attend to.
What is it about nursing that you like?
I just like helping people, and just that's the job that, I don't know, maybe 3 years ago it came up, and I've been following that dream ever since.
What's it like being a part of this community where sports are, you know, you're crazy for sports, but it's family-oriented, you know, Fort Recovery. Just kind of talk about growing up here.
Well, it's awesome. I mean, every single Friday night for basketball games, there's going to be people packing the house, football games packing the field, and baseball, you got support all around. It's just awesome to know that everyone has your back in the community, and they're always going to support you.
You talked about your line. Just what does that mean to a running back, seeing those big guys in front of you?
Well, it's incredible that I had probably the best offensive line in four-year football history for 2 years to run behind, and then next year we'll be good again too. So the offensive line is what built our team, and that's what we try to build our team off of.
Do you feel like they deserve some hustle awards too?
Yeah, I mean, without this award, that means nothing without them. I'm getting sacked in the backfield every single time if it's not for the linemen.
All right, congratulations.
Thank you.
Powell passes for it on fourth down. And nice little trick play there to Spicer, and he's going to take it all the way in for a touchdown. And that line is moving. They had a plus one first down, and this is Spicer again. He's off to the races and into the end zone for a touchdown. First and 10. Spicer going out wide, cuts it back in, has a seam, and takes it all the way in for a touchdown. Spicer's third touchdown of the night, 25 yards out.
So what's the word hustle mean to you, Eric Spicer?
Just giving everything that you've got for yourself, for your team, just making everybody make sure you give everything you've got for your team, for your community, for just everybody that you're playing for.
You were the hustle winner for the Salina game. What a great game to win that for. Yeah. Rivalry game, just what did that game mean every year?
It means something every year. Something a little bit special. I mean, you know everybody from the other town. A little bit of smack talk goes on every single year, but at the end of the day, it's just friendly rivalry. It's always a big game, biggest game of the year. That's the one you always want to win.
Special senior season for you. What are some things that stick out?
Just the bond that we built all the way from freshman year to senior year. It went by really fast, but coming from 3 years ago where we were at, being 0-20 to what we accomplished this year, I mean, it was a big accomplishment. It's something that we feel like we'll always have a bond together, and it's just something really special that we have.
Making it back to the playoffs, what did that mean for the town?
It meant a lot for the town, for the whole community. For us as players, it's something we always dreamed of as kids. And then, as I just mentioned, freshman year, I mean, we weren't going anywhere. I mean, what we wanted to get to was not in the foreseeable future at all. So just getting there later in our careers, it was something really special, and it's memories that we won't forget.
Running track now, what's the goal for this next month and a half?
Goal for the next month and a half is hopefully make it to state. That's been our goal every year since freshman year when we made it. So we've came up short the past couple years, but it's always a keep our goals high. That's what we're shooting for.
How do you approach track personally?
I've been taking it a little bit more serious since I think I started off freshman year. I didn't really know a whole lot about it. I came out as it came out for just to get more work in for football a little bit, get more conditioned. But as I got along with it and learned the sport a little bit more, I started to grow and love it, and then going to state. Experiencing success, it's been something great. So I just come into it with a positive attitude, hard work ethic, and it's something that's really it's been fun in high school.
And then the next chapter in your life, headed to the Naval Academy. Just take us through that decision.
It was a big one. I'm not gonna lie. I hadn't really thought about it a whole lot until about junior year. It hit me. I needed somewhere to go, and I've had a lot of family. My father, my grandfather, both in the Navy. My uncle was an officer in the Air Force. So it was something big for me, and I decided I wanted to be the first naval officer in our family, first one to go to an academy. I had a lot of help from Rhonda Shelby. She was a great help in the application process. It was really taxing on your mind at some times going through that whole application process, having to go through interviews with Jim Jordan's committee, Rob Portman's committee. But in the end, it'll all be worth it, and I'm really excited for June 27th when I leave and to spend the next few years in Annapolis.
Do they give you an assignment right away, or does that come with time?
No, not right away. You actually get to go for your first 2 years before you actually sign your commitment into the military. So if one so chooses, they can choose to leave or not be in the military before their first 2 years, which I fully plan on having a career in the military if you're going to put that kind of time in. But, so you don't have your assignment right away. I've looked at a little bit as being going into aviation a little bit, so flying. But that's a decision I can make down the road, so I'm just excited for the opportunity right now.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Stockwell calls his own number and is going to be, looks like he stopped short initially with second effort. Third and 23. Pritchard has time. Looking, going up for it. And Jefferson got it. Jace Stockwell.
Who else?
Stolle Hustle Award winner for the Spencerville game. Always a great rivalry game. What did that mean to get the victory and also get named Stolle Hustle Award?
That means a lot to me. It's definitely a game we circle on the calendar every year, obviously.
And when we're able to win it, it makes our season.
Losing your voice because you never stop. Basketball season, you are sixth in the Stolly Hustle voting, and you're playing baseball right now. Do you ever take a day off?
It seems like I don't. It's football, we end it on a Saturday. I'm practicing basketball on a Monday. Basketball, we end on a Saturday. I'm practicing baseball on a Monday, and we're already got baseball games going now.
And a tough start to start the season. I mean, Van Wert to open the season, then you beat Kaleida. You guys are getting tested right off the bat.
Yep, we got a good win yesterday against Kaleida that really got us some confidence going after a tough doubleheader on Saturday.
Football season, what's it like, you know, to strap it up? You're done, obviously, in your high school career, but what will you remember?
It's an unbelievable feeling. It's just something you cherish every Friday night, going out with your teammates, your brothers, and it's a sad thing when it's over.
Do you want to play in college? What are the plans next for Jay Stockwell?
I considered playing at the Division II level, but I've decided I'm just going to focus on my education at Bowling Green.
Okay. What's your major?
Intervention specialist.
Very nice. So going to be a coach someday, maybe?
Yeah, I plan on it.
Coaching in Chris Summers' shoes. You'll be the next one, right?
Yep. I hope to eventually come back to my hometown and coach.
What does hustle mean to you when you think of that word?
That means everything to me. I mean, hustle, that brings about heart and just what kind of grit you have, and that's what kind of player I think I am.
It's toughing it out through an interview when you have no voice.
Yep.
All right, congratulations. Five very deserving football candidates, and now we present five very deserving basketball candidates, our All-Stolly Hustle Award hoops team.
Now Overholt trapped in that press, and he passes it away. Now pass up to Lessing. Lessing goes up with it in and the foul, and he'll have another try at the three-point play. Here's Lessing with the ball at the top, pulls up for the jumper, and good. Rager misses a three pulled in by Johnson. Johnson ahead to a sprinting Lessing who gets it and puts it up, and Lincoln View is going to have to take a timeout here. Ball underneath to Lessing. Lessing powers it up, uses that big frame to get up and put that in the basket. Pumping out this zone defense as Lessing gets it inside, puts it up, no, gets his own rebound, puts it up and in, and he's fouled, and he'll get an extra one from the line.
Well, what does this mean to be an All-Hustle Award team member?
Well, it's a great honor to represent Fairlawn and just the season that we had, and just great honor to show the success we had this season.
Talk about that season with your team. Some great seniors. It ended earlier than you wanted it to, but what were some of the special moments?
Well, just playing with all the seniors since, like, fifth grade and just coming together, good coach, having – play together, and just came together as a good season for us too, but we didn't have the ending that we wanted to, obviously, but it was a fun season.
Special game against Lincoln View. That's when you were named the Hustle Award winner. A nice win near the end of the season at home for you.
Yeah, it was fun for you guys to come down to show that game. We had a lot of fun, and it was just a good game, really fast-paced game, but I'm just glad we won it.
Shelby County's all-time leading scorer. You passed Tom Brandon. What did that mean? Then he reached out to you on Twitter as well once you passed that. What did that mean to you?
Well, at first I didn't really want to think about it to affect my teammates or how I played on the court. But now that season's over, it's a really great honor. And it was nice of him to reach out to me, congratulate me. I really liked that and appreciated it.
It's hard to score points in the Shelby County League. How were you able to score so many? I mean, it's a defensive, tough league that you guys were able to get points.
Well, I have to thank my teammates and coach. They're great to play with, and they just got me the ball whenever I was open. And it is hard, very hard during some games. But, yeah, like I said, they gave me the ball. Coaches draw plays up, and all the credit goes to them.
Up next, you'll be here in Lima, UNOH. Coach Caleb Williams, the new head coach. What does he mean to you first off as your new head coach, and how excited are you for the Racers?
Well, I first met him in AAU season when he was recruiting me, and I really liked talking to him. Went up there on a visit, and he was really fun to talk to, and being around the teammates and stuff, I'm really looking forward to it.
All right, well, congratulations on your Stolly Hustle Award winner.
Thank you.
Directing traffic early on, Brady Hipscher, and almost has the ball stolen away. Does have the ball stolen away. Numbers for Perry, and that one put up and in for the first points tonight. Jacoby Lane Harvey.
This
passes him in the paint. It is in, and that's it. Jacoby Lane Harvey, 1,000 points for Perry. And he gets a standing ovation, and he'll go to the free throw line to add to his milestone.
There's a steal by Lane Harvey. He'll push the issue, 1-on-5, and gets it in. Twelve points tonight for Lane Harvey, the four-point lead, and there's the steal. So Lane Harvey, right hand and in. And just like that, turnovers turning into points for the Commodores. It's a two-point Ram lead.
We got the Hustle Award for a big league game early in the season, beat Upper Souda Valley. That kind of set the tone for you guys in the NWCC, didn't it? Getting out to a good start against USV.
Yeah, I think that was good. Us winning that game let them know that we're coming and we're still hungry for that this year, well, last year.
And lots of hunger all season long. Just what was this year like? You knew you guys were all shooting for this. Senior year, this is going to be our year, and you really lived it out this year.
We lived it up. I think that was the best thing going down the state. That was our go-to thing. That's what we wanted for this whole season. So I think that was great to get down there and keep pushing. We didn't get the win, but it was still great.
Tell us about that state week. What do you remember leading up to going down and then your whole experience in Columbus? What was it like?
It was great. I think the pep rally before we left was fun. The kids were screaming our names. All the little kids were there. And then when we got down there, it was just like we got treated like royalty. We got free dinners every night. I think that was the best. We got to choose where we wanted to eat. And
so where'd you guys go?
We went to Raising Cane's twice. so it really wasn't a choice. But it was fun, though. The arena is really nice, and then the staff down there treated us really, really well.
Obviously, the game didn't go the way you wanted to in the state semifinal, but that start, I mean, getting out to a 9-0 start, what was the feeling like in that arena with all that red and you guys were leading?
It felt amazing. I just thought at that moment we were going to win the game by at least 20. We were just pushing. We was making shots. I think we were getting up and down the floor, and I think that was the go-to, but I guess we couldn't finish the game.
What will you remember from this year as you move forward 10 years from now, talking to your teammates? What types of things do you think you guys will talk about?
The playing on that arena and warming up. I think everybody was shooting around, even the players that didn't get in. They were just out there shooting around, just having fun. So I think the warm-up was pretty fun and goofy.
Coach Tabler, do you have a good Coach Tabler story?
Oh, good. There's so many. I think him just yelling at me. I think every practice he yelled at me. So I think it's a lot of memories.
Did that help you hustle? We're talking Stolly Hustle Award here. Did that help you motivate you?
Yeah. Some nights it made me sad. Some nights it made me hustle. But most of the time he was just trying to push me. So I think that's really what got me.
And you want to play college basketball. That's the next goal for you, right?
Yeah, that's the next goal. I don't know where, but I'm attend a college for basketball.
All right. Well, great high school career. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Here comes McDonald. He's going to catch a high screen from Sweeney. McDonald off glass, and it goes again.
Wow. Tough shot.
There goes McDonald to the rim again. If he wants to go right hand, just goes.
It doesn't matter who you got back inside. If you're going to let him dribble through the zone, you're in trouble.
We're here at the Elida Fieldhouse, familiar venue, as Shawnee took home the tournament title in the start of the year, the tip-off tournament. What memories do you have from the beginning of the year?
Great memories. It's great. It was a great feeling to win tip-off, especially something I've been a part of Shawnee basketball program since I was really little, man, since my dad was coaching when I was at a young age, and it was just nice to get a win, which Shawnee hasn't done in a while.
You guys had a great first half to the season. What was that like, stringing those wins together, getting some excitement?
It was really exciting, especially for the community, because it was just great, like, especially after we won tip-off, just looking up and seeing how happy, like, Shawnee's fans were. You just haven't seen that in a while.
What will you remember 5 years from now, 10 years from now, about your Shawnee senior season?
Winning tip-off.
You'll come back every year, won't you?
Yeah, I will. Definitely.
Certainly bragging rights. That's what guys do. Hustle, the word hustle. You're an all-hustle award team member here. What's that mean to you?
Hustling, that's what wins games to me. If you don't hustle, you're not going to win games. If you don't get loose balls, you always have to have guys that hustle on your team. And my dad's always preached that to me, that I have to hustle. And that's what I've done.
So that's something at a very early age was ingrained upon you.
Yeah, it was, especially since I was young in high school coming in. Jaden O'Neal, everyone knows him. He was a scorer, one of the best in the area. So I kind of just had to hustle to play. I got to get minutes. I had to hustle. So,
is your favorite shot with 5 seconds left outside the arc? Because I saw you hitting, you know, buzzer beater after buzzer beater, it seemed like this season.
Yeah, that's my favorite shot. Yeah, it is. That's my favorite shot outside the arc. I mean, it's nice to get the hole if you can, but a lot of people like to settle.
Congratulations on the All Hustle team.
Thank you.
Here's Ward. He'll jack it up from deep in the left corner. And Jarius Ward with his points, a three-pointer.
And now a turnover. Lima Senior's going to get it. Ward's going to go up with it. And another 2 points for Ward. 11 of 11 points.
That is a definite change. Look at that. A breakdown on the backside, down on the bottom, but he'll miss it.
You know why? Quiñones got back and he had to avoid the travel charge right there.
And look at Quiñones after the rebound on the break makes an excellent bounce pass feed ahead to Jarius Ward, who lays it up and in. Step back, Quiñones, he's really feeling it. Missed that one. Tip up and in, Jarius Ward.
Jar Ward winning for the Lima Senior versus OG game. What do you remember about that game?
I just remember that the game was a rival. I remember Coach Q just preaching that this team is a good team. I believe they were like third or fourth in the state at the time. So I kind of just wanted to put my team on my back and come out with the victory.
Yeah, 20 points in that game, a lot of hustle, but the real newsmaker was maybe the next week when you hit a buzzer-beating three to beat St. Francis. What do you remember about that shot?
The whole game was crazy. The game was just excitement. It was tough. It was a lot of competing. And the shot was a great shot. I kind of knew I had a chance, actually, once I let it go in my hands. And I seen that it was on target, so I knew that it kind of had a chance to go in, and then it just happened to go in and be a miracle.
So be honest, was that hustle? Was that luck? Was that skill?
I think it was just hard work paying off. Like, it's always a saying that hard work does pay off. And I kind of I was going hard that week just because I was preparing for those two big games that we had. And I just feel like that was rewarded to me from hard work.
Safe to say that's your favorite game of the year?
Yes, definitely.
So what does hustle mean to you?
Hustle to me is just heart. Like, it starts with heart. If you have heart, you can do anything. I talk to Tyler Ulis a lot. And that's all he's kind of preaches to the young guys that's coming up, me, Xavier, us. He just says heart. And with him, it's pretty big because he's 5'9", and he's doing things that people can't even do 6 foot. So I believe just hustle is heart. It just starts with the heart. If you have heart, then you're a hustler.
What does Coach Simpson do to motivate hustle out of you?
He just makes us go hard at everything. Once again, he makes sure as we touch the lines, well, even if that's just up and down, he makes sure that we're touching the lines. He makes sure that everyone's going hard. And he just makes sure that he's doing his job by getting his point across to us.
This was your senior season. What memories will you take from the program?
Leadership. This was a big role for me because last year I didn't have to play a big role of leadership. So my senior year, Lima Senior, I will always remember just how people remember me as a leader.
And any decisions about any future plans?
I'm going to decide in about a week or so. So that's where we'll go from there.
We'll look forward to that. Congratulations.
Master Lasko. He'll work left side, drive. Comes back baseline, reverse layup is good.
He has 8 of Liberty-Benton's 10 points. They left him alone at the free throw line.
No.
That's not what they want to do on a regular basis.
Giving away lots of height.
And he gets the shooter's roll, does Master Lasko, and a foul.
We're off the rim, no good. Rebound, Master Lasko. Master Lasko will drive to the rack, count it in one.
There you go. So you double team Master Lasko.
Here's a dunk.
And that was off the left hand.
The tempo has increased, fans on their feet. Anthony thought about the three, said, why? I can get to the rim every time, and he's over 1,000. 1,000, 1 point.
Here's the inbounds, Master Lasko.
Oh, my goodness.
You just can't give Master Lasko an open court. You just cannot stop him on an open court.
The last couple of times, once he gets through the first line of defense, they pretty much let him go because they're going to have to foul him.
Oh, buddy.
Case in point.
Drop step move. That's outstanding.
42.
Special senior season for you. Well, how did it feel different this year, first of all, going from junior season to senior season? It seemed like you took your game to a whole new level.
In the offseason, I feel like I worked a lot on my game. Just at some positions I felt like I was good at, but in the offseason I want to make it where I was great at it, you know, just like improve my game a lot and probably focus more on my shooting. That was a kind of a downfall last year for my junior year, so that was probably my main focus during the offseason.
A lot of questions about Liberty-Benton going into the season. How good could this team really be? And then you just went out and won the BVC championship. What was that like for you guys to gain confidence?
It felt great getting the third one in a row. After losing Nathan Kraft, he was one of our best players, and we didn't really know if we could refill that role. But a bunch of players stepped up, worked hard in the offseason. We were able to get it done.
You got the Stolle Hustle Award for a game where you had all kinds of milestones, went over 1,000 points, broke the school scoring record. At what point did you say, wow, what a game that was that we just had beating our rival, Van Buren?
Yeah, that was a crazy night. But I didn't really look at it until probably the next morning when I woke up and like, wow, that just happened. Definitely something crazy. It was a great night, especially with my teammates. And just getting that win over Van Buren was huge.
What was that atmosphere like all night long there at Liberty Benton?
Oh, that was an amazing atmosphere. Just definitely something I'm going to look back at and be like, just wow, it's crazy.
When you think of the word hustle, what comes to mind? When is it this time of year when you're starting to grind for next year? You know, what does it come to mind?
I think hustle right now, probably lifting, getting stronger, working on the little things in my game, ball handling, shooting, preparing myself for next year, especially playing at the collegiate level. So, I mean, that's something that's really important you got to start working on.
Yeah, staying in Findlay, headed to the University of Findlay there. What has Coach Ernst said you got to work on to get to this next level next year?
Yeah, I just talked to him recently about what I have to improve on, and he's going to send us like links and things that we have to work on and lifting-wise, and we're going to be starting to head over there in June, so I'm really excited about that too. So, yeah, it should be fun.
What made you choose Findlay?
Findlay, I've been following them my whole life, ever since I was like 4 years old when we moved here, and just the coaches, the team, everything about it just really stood out, especially the program they have. It's been very, very successful these last for a while now. Yeah.
And speaking of the successful Liberty Benton, I think about Aaron Kraft. He's a hustle guy. He always has been. And he reached out to you after you broke that record that was his, by the way. What did that mean to hear from him?
Oh, that meant a lot. I mean, I worked out with him a little bit in the summer and just never really thought about breaking his scoring record. And then after that game, I'm like, wow, I just did that. And I got a text from him and a tweet from him, and I thought, wow, that's pretty cool.
All right, well, congratulations on all the hustle this year. Good luck at Findlay.
Appreciate it.
Special to relive some great moments from the football season and basketball season with 10 very deserving young men who are gonna do some great things in life. Thanks once again to our friends at Stolle Insurance for providing this great award to honor some great high school athletes.
Thank you, Andy, we appreciate it.
Stolle Insurance, hustle teams right here on WOSN.